My Family History, a look into the past. My grandmother is the daughter of a British interpreter born and raised in Cairo, Egypt. Now, at 85, she looks back on the country she has lived in and how her life and her family have been formed.
I'm Evelyn McCoy, who started all this mess. I was born in Cairo, Egypt in 1926. I had a brother 14 months later, and then I had another brother 10 years later. I met my future husband, and then we left for Oregon. I was working at the British Consul and had a Maltese girlfriend, and she wanted to go out on a date. And when a Greek fellow called her to go on for a date, the Greek fellow brought my husband. But she was closer to the Greek fellow's age, and I was closer to my husband Mac's age. So we went out as a foursome, and that's how it started. So my parents spoke Maltese. I picked it up. Then my mother and I spoke French because I went to a French school. And then the help in the house was Arabic, Egyptian. So there's three languages already. Mm-hmm. Then my aunt and my mother spoke Greek, and I picked that up. And then when I came to the States, when my fifth child went to school, I went to school too. I went to the local college, junior college, and I took Spanish and German. Then I went to Mexico and stayed with Mexican family. That's when you really learn the language. Mm-hmm. To say hello, you say "Che fint?" How are you? And in Italian, "Come stai?" In French, "Comment allez-vous?" In Arabic, "Ezayak?" In Greek, "Tikanis?" What else did I miss? I got married in Cairo, 1945. Just when the war was over, in a big cathedral called St. Joseph. Strangely enough, I go to St. Joseph here too in Lincoln.
How long did you know him before you moved to the United States, all the way across the world?
Almost a year. Well, my mother was pleased. My father wasn't too pleased for me going so far away. I got shipped out with a military ship. It wasn't luxurious, but it was big. And there were 21 berths in my stateroom. I met a lot of girls, had good friends. All the girls were sick. I used to go down and steal food for them. And that's the way I came. And my husband joined me later. When I got to Oregon, they didn't even have running water in the farm. They just put it in while I was there. And then about 9 months later, Elaine was born in Salem. My husband went back into the army because he was in the reserves. So we went to Boise, Idaho, where Kim was born. And from there, we moved to Columbus, Ohio. And then we went to Germany.
My name is William George McCoy. I'm the fifth of my mother's children and father's children, my mother Evelyn Jane McCoy, and my father Leonard James McCoy. I was born in 1959 in Frankfurt, Germany, and the war is what really brought us there. My father was in the U.S. Army, and he was a quartermaster with supplies. Very, very key man with supplying the different areas of war with what they needed to exist. So he was very important, moved very, very frequently. In 1961, my father and the whole family, me being the fifth now, we all came to Monterey, California, so that my father could work out of Fort Ord, which was a military installation, but in the beautiful Monterey Peninsula. And we remained there as a family until about 1969. Where my sister closest to me, Kathleen, and myself and my mother went back to Europe. because that's where her family was from, and spent a number of years there, about 5 years, better part of 5 years. We lived in Sicily, we lived in Malta, we lived in England, visited the Isle of Man, got to go to some just beautiful places all over Europe. It was a different type of lifestyle. I think it really helped shape who I am and who my sister and I are, as it shaped my entire family as they moved around, because we were exposed to so many different types of people, different cultures, just different beliefs and different ways of spending your time in your life. So the European experience was just tremendous. Moving around from, let's say, California to Europe, or one location in Europe to another location, was a very, very good experience in a lot of ways. It helped my sister and I to grow very, very close, because we were the only common thing, of course, with my mother, that we could relate to. Languages were different, the food you ate was different, the clothes you wore were, you know, you wore what you brought, but as we lived there, we got into the culture more, bought the type of clothes that the people wear there, and you, the schools are very, very different. If you didn't do your homework, which, you know, some of us McCoys can be rebellious, they'd whack your back of your knuckles with a yardstick, and things like that.
Fuiste la razón de mi existir, adorarte para mí fue religión.
En tus brazos se encontraba el amor que me brindaba, el calor de tu pasión.
Es la historia de un amor como no hay otro igual, que me hizo comprender.
I went to 13 schools before I graduated, by the time I graduated high school. Mm-hmm. So, let's see, I moved from, we started in Ohio, and then Germany, then California, that's Monterey, then England, then Malta, then Sicily, then Rancho Cordova, then
California.
Yeah, in California, and then let's see, Seaside, Pacific Grove. Yeah.
And when we lived in Sicily, we lived on a house. We rented the bottom part of a villa that was
on the beach.
On the beach, but the beach was all made from lava. From Mount Etna, the active volcano that was there in Sicily. And we could look out our bedroom window and see the glowing dome of Mount Etna, which was pretty cool. We look out our bedroom window and see it. And then the house was right on the lava rock, built right onto the lava rock. And so there was no real beach, it was all lava rock. And you could go out and sit on the rocks, dive off the rocks, but it was in the winter that the storms would come, and the big waves would come right up to almost at the front steps. For us, we'd go to the beach, we'd go get on the bus and ride around the island, and this.
You went to military base, navy base.
Oh, that was in Sicily. This, mm-hmm. I'm talking about Malta, and Malta was a very, very welcoming country for being so small. Well, my dad was pretty much a military man's military man. He, you know, he was gone a lot, and he was not a very, attentive father. Yeah, mom was mom and dad to all of us, pretty much. And my dad did what he could. He came from a very large family, 12 kids.
And so, you know, he was raised on a farm, and, you know, there was a lot of structure when he grew up. And so, you know, we were very structured in how the house was run. But then he would be gone, like, he went to Vietnam. He went once or twice?
Once to
Vietnam.
San Francisco.
And then he was transferred to the Presidio of San Francisco for a while. So he was gone a lot.
So he was one with a very strong work ethic. He learned that from the military. He was very, very successful in his career. Not physically present with us very much from the eyes of a child, but my father was a very good provider, and he did what he was driven to do, and that was be successful in the U.S. Army. He did a good job for the United States. About 1974, and Kathleen came back as well. And my father at that point was at the Presidio of Monterey, where he spent his last few years before he retired from the U.S. Army as a full colonel.
War has given me family. From Egypt to California, it has brought my grandma and grandpa together. And together, they created my dad, which in turn helped create me. So without war, who would I be?